एक्सरसाइज 4.3, बट बिफोर द स्टार्टिंग द एक्सरसाइज नंबर 4.3, हियर इन विच द ग्राफ ऑफ अ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन अ टू वेरिएबल. सो यू नीड टू रिमेंबर द वन थिंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इफ वी हैव द लीनियर इक्वेशन, सो ग्राफ इज ऑलवेज अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. क्लियर? ग्राफ इज ऑलवेज अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. सो वी कैन स्टार्ट विथ अवर क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. सो हियर दे आर आस्किंग, ड्रॉ द ग्राफ ऑफ ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग लीनियर इक्वेशन इन अ टू वेरिएबल. सो हियर सी द इक्वेशन इज गिवन, एक्स प्लस वाई इज इक्वल टू 4. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू फाइंड द 4 और अ 5 सॉल्यूशन, एंड फ्रॉम दैट सॉल्यूशन यू कैन प्लॉट द ग्राफ. सो दिस यू कैन डू दैट ऑल सम इन योर ग्राफ बुक ओनली. क्लियर? एक्सरसाइज फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 4.3 ऑनवर्ड्स, इफ यू हैव द ग्राफिकल क्वेश्चन, सो यू कैन डायरेक्टली राइट डाउन इन योर ग्राफ बुक, एंड द कैलकुलेशन यू कैन प्लॉट ऑन द बिलो पेज. Now first equation is x plus y is equal to 4. So first of all we can also write like that, 4 minus y, because this is going second set, so it become minus. Now we will take the different value of y, 1, then minus 1, 2 and minus 2. We can take the 5 different value. Now put in this equation, so 4 minus 0, so first answer is 4. So x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 0. Once again, now we will put 1. So 4 minus 1, it is 3. So answer is 3 comma 1. Then put minus 1. So minus minus become plus. So answer it is 5. So 5 comma minus 1. Then put x, y is equal to 2. So 4 minus 2, answer it is 2, so 2 comma 2. Then y is equal to once again minus 2, so minus minus plus, so answer it is 6, so 6 comma minus 2. So what is our chart? So here first of all I am writing y, and here I am writing x is equal to 4 minus y. Now first of all we are taking 0, then 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. If we put 0, answer it is 4, then 3, 5, 2 and 6. So from this we can plot our graph. So here first of all 0. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5 and minus 6. It is our x and it is our y axis, y dash. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. Now first point is 4 comma 0. So 4 comma 0 is here, then 3 comma 1, so 3 and 1, so both are matching here, then 5 comma minus 1, 5 comma minus 1, 2 comma 2, 2 comma 2. Then 6 comma minus 2, 6 and minus 2. So you can see that this is our straight line. It is always our straight line. So this is the equation for x plus y is equal to 4. Clear? You can take the one more point. So you can, if you taking the more point here, so graph is more straight. Clear? So it is always a straight line. Now for a question 2. So first and second both are similar. X plus y is equal to 4. And here we have a x minus y is equal to 2. So first of all we can start. X is equal to, we can write 2 plus y. This y is going second set, so it become plus. Now we can take the different value of y, 0, 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. So now x is equal to 2, first of all we put 0, so 0 plus 2 it is 2, then 1, so it is 3, then 2 plus minus 1, plus minus minus, 2 minus 1, then 2, so it is 4. Then 2 minus plus in bracket minus 2. So plus minus minus 2 minus 2 it is 0. So what is our point? Here I am writing y and here I am writing x is equal to 2 plus y. Then 0, 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. Now if we put y is equal to 0, answer it is 2. Then 3, 1, 4 and 0. So what is x? 2 comma 0, then 3 comma 1, 1 comma minus 1, 4 comma 2. First of all you can always write x coordinate and then you can write a y coordinate only. Then 0 comma minus 2. Now draw its graph. So here x, x dashed, y, y dash. So here I am writing 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and here I am writing minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. Now next, first coordinate it is 2 comma 0, so it is here 2 comma 0, then 3 comma 1, 3 comma 1, so it is here, then 1 comma minus 1, 1 and minus 1, so it is here, then 4 comma 2, 4 comma 2. Then 0 comma minus 2, 0 and it is y it is minus 2, so it is here. So if we drawing that line, so it is always a straight line, clear? So it is a graph for x minus y is equal to 2. Now similarly for a third, so in a third they are saying y is equal to 3x. In this they are directly give us the equation, so we can put the different value of x. First of all 0, then 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. So y is equal to 3 in bracket 0, so 3 into 0, 3, then 1, so 3 ones are 3, sorry here we have a 0, then 3 in bracket minus 1, so minus 3, 3 and bracket 2, so it is 6, 3 in bracket minus 2, it is minus 6. Now we plot the graph for same. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. So first coordinate is 0 comma 0. We can also draw the chart like here x and y is equal to 3x, then 0, 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. So what is the value of y? 0, 3, minus 3, 6 and minus 6. So first coordinate it is 0 comma 0, so it is here 0 comma 0, then 1 comma 3, 1 comma 3, so it is here, then minus 1 comma minus 3, minus 1 and minus 3, so it is here, then 2 comma 6, 2 and here we have a 6, so it is here. Next minus 2 comma minus 6, what is here? So it is our straight line, clear? It is our straight line graph, and it is a graph for which y is equal to 3x. Here we can write x, x dash, y, y dash. Now last question, 3 is equal to 2x plus y, fourth. So we can also write like that, if this 2x is going second side, so y is equal to 3 minus 2x, clear? We can write this y, this 2x is going second side, so it become minus. Now we will take x is equal to 0, 1, then minus 1, 2 and minus 2. So y is equal to 3 in bracket 2, 0, so 2 into 0, 0, answer it is 3. 2 ones are 2, so 3 minus 2 is 1. Next, 3 minus 1, minus minus become plus, so it is 5. Then 2 in bracket 2, so 2 twos are 4, 3 minus 4, it is minus 1. Then minus 2, so minus minus become plus, so 4 plus 3, it is 7. So what is its chart? Here I am writing y, sorry x, and y is equal to 3 minus 2, 0, 1, minus 1, 2 and minus 2. So we can get, here we can get 3, 1, 5, minus 1 and 7. Now we can plot its graph. Here we have a 0 x, x dashed, y, y dash, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 1. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. Now 0 comma 3, so 0 comma 3 it is here, then 1 comma 1, so 1 comma 1, so it is here, then minus 1 comma plus 5, so it is here, then 2 comma minus 1, 2 comma minus 1, so it is here. Then minus 2 comma 7, so 6 and 7, you can write 6 and 7, so it is here. So graph is a straight line now, clear? Here I am not taking the exactly measurement, so it will be the little bit change. But if you draw in your graph book, so you can get the exactly the straight line. So it is a graph for y is equal to 3 minus 2x. So you can plot the all the graph in that kind of graph book only. Exercise 4.3, question number 2. So here they are asking, give the equation of a 2 line passing through. So here we have one point is given, 2 comma 14. So how many more such lines are there and why? So from the point you can make the linear equation with two variables. So how it is possible? So first of all, see that here the x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 14 is given. So we can write like that, x plus y is equal to what? If x is 2 and y is equal to 14, so answer 16, 14 plus 2. So what is our first equation? X plus y is equal to 16, clear? Because it satisfied our condition. See that if we put x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 14, so 14 plus 2, answer it is 16, so it satisfied our condition, clear? So we can write like that, first equation is x plus y is equal to 16. You can make the one more similar type, like 8x minus y is equal to 2. How? See that if you put x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 14, so 8 to the 16 minus 14, so it is 2, so it is our satisfied our condition. So it is our second equation, 8x minus y is equal to 2. So similarly, you can also make the from the point, you can make the number of equation, clear, number of linear equation with a 2 variable. So now question number 3. So now question number 3, if the point 3, 4 lies on the graph of the equation, so equation is given as well as point is also given, so they are asking find the value of a. So first of all, we can write equation 3y is equal to a x plus 7. So now y is equal to 4 and x is equal to 3, so y is replaced with 4 and x is replaced with 3. So 4 3s are 12, that is going second side. So 12 minus 7, so it is 5. So what is the value of a? It is going second side, so a is equal to 5 by 3. Now next, this is our question number 4. So taxi fare in a city is as follow. Suppose you can see in our any of the city we have the taxi fare, so it is fixed. So the situation is given, for the first kilometer the fare is 8 rupees. If you traveling up to the 1 kilometer, so you need to pay the 8 rupees. And for the subsequent distance, then after 1 kilometer you need to pay the rupees 5. Suppose you are traveling 2 kilometers, so 8 plus 5, so you need to pay the 13 rupees. And if you are traveling 3 kilometers, so 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 8, it is 18 rupees, like that. So taking the distance cover is x kilometer. So they are directly saying distance cover is x kilometer. So here we can write distance travel, it is x kilometer. And total fare is rupees y. So we can also here write total fare is y. So write the linear equation for this information. So total fare is equal to what? Fare for a first kilometer plus fare for a remaining kilometer. So total fare, it is given y, and fare for a first kilometer, it is also fixed 8 rupees. Then for a remaining, phi in bracket x minus 1. Why we are writing here x minus 1? Because it is for a subsequent distance. Clear? It is for a remaining or a subsequent distance. Now simplify this. So 8, phi into x, so 5x, 5, 1s are 5. So y is equal to 8 minus 5, it is 3. So it is our equation. Clear? 8y is equal to 3 plus 5x. Now put the different value of x. Suppose we are starting with 1 kilometer, then 2. Here we are taking only the positive integer. Why? Because distance is always in a positive integer. So 1 kilometer, 2, then 3, up to 4. 4 kilometer. We can write up to the 4 kilometer only. So if we put x is equal to 1, so 3 in bracket. So 5 ones are 5, 5 plus 3 it is 8. If you are traveling up to the 2 kilometer, so 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 3, 13 rupees. Then 3, so 15 plus 3 it is 18. So 20, 20 plus 3 it is 23. Clear? So like that. Now they are also asking write a linear equation and also draw its graph. So here x, on a y we are taking a scale because here the digit are more. So on a y axis we are taking a square. So we can draw its graph like that. X, X, X. y dash. On a y axis we are taking a 1 centimeter scale. 1 centimeter is equal to 5. Clear? 1 centimeter is equal to 5 unit. You can also take the 2. So it is easy for us. 2 or a 5. It is depend on us. So here I am writing 1, 2, 3 and 4. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here, then here we are taking a scale. So here 5, then 10, 15, 20, then 25. Here minus 5, minus 10, minus 15, then minus 20, because we are taking a 1 centimeter is equal to 5. So now 1 comma 8, so 1 and it is 8 here. So first point is here. Then 2 comma 13, 2 comma 13. Then 3 comma 18, 3 comma 18. Then 4 comma 23, 4 comma 23. So graph is like that. Here graph is like that. It is 4 y is equal to 3 plus 5x. Clear? So we can draw the graph for our question number 4. Now we are going to our next question, question number 5. So here they are saying that two figures are given. Choose the equation whose graph is given in 4.6. So it is our 4.6 and it is our figure number 4.7. So graph is given. So from the graph we can choose any of one option is correct. Clear? So for that here 3 points is given. See, minus 1 comma 1, then 0 comma 0, and then 1 comma minus 1. So now put the each value in this graph. So which equation satisfied these 3 points? So it is our solution. So we can start with our first, y is equal to x. So here first of all, if you put x is equal to minus 1, then y is equal to 1. So these both are not matching. Clear? Left hand side is not matched with the right hand side. So it is a not a solution for a first. Clear? Second, x plus y is equal to 0. So we can put x is equal to minus 1 and then y is equal to plus 1. So answer is 0. So it is matched with our second. Clear? So it means what? Second equation, these three, we can also put 0. So 0 plus 0, it is also 0. Then x is equal to 1 and y is equal to minus 1. So 1 plus minus minus. So these three equation, these three here, the 3 point given, and if we put these 3 point in our this second number equation, so it satisfied the all the condition. So it means what? X plus, it is a graph for x plus y. Clear? This graph is for a x plus y is equal to 0, because it's we can also check for a second like that. We can write the equation x plus y is equal to 0. Then first point is minus 1 comma 1. So minus 1 plus 1, answer is 0. Then 0 comma 0, once again it satisfied. Then 1 comma minus 1. So in each case they are satisfied our condition. Now we can also check for our third. So here if we put x is equal to, first of all, minus 1 comma minus 1. So y is equal to 2x. So y is equal to 1 and x is equal. So 1 is equal to minus 2. So these both are not matching. Clear? So it is not a graph for our third. We can also check for our fourth. 2 plus 3y is equal to 7x. Now we will put our first point. Y is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 1. So 3 ones are 3, 3 plus 2 5, 7 ones are minus 7. So once again these are not satisfied over that first point. So it means what? Second option is the right, because if we put this all 3 points in our question, in our option 2, so it satisfied all our conditions. So we can write like that. It is a graph for x plus y is equal to 0. Now 4.7 is same as our 4.6. Clear? Question 5, second, figure 4.7, they have the same question as our 4.6 figure. So first of all, you need to put this all point. First point is minus 1, 3, then 0, 2, and 2, 0. So now you will put this. So we can start with first. First of all, put y is equal to 3. X is equal to minus 1. So 2 minus 1, it is 1. So these both are not matching. So it means what? This is not a graph for that. This is not a graph for that equation. Now for a second, y is equal to x minus 2. Now y is equal to 3 and x is equal to minus 1. So minus 3, 3. Once again, it is not matching. Now for a third, y is equal to minus x plus 2. So put y is equal to 3, x is equal to minus 1, minus minus plus. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So it is match. We can also check for a 0, 2. Put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to, x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2. So 2. 0 plus 2, so 2 is equal to 2, so these both are once again match. So we can say that what? It is a graph for y is equal to minus x plus 2. You can also check fourth option. We can put x is equal to minus 1, then y is equal to 3, so 3 to the 6. 6 minus 1, 5. Once again, these both are not matching. So it is not a graph for x plus 2y is equal to 6. Question number 6. If the work done by the body on application of a constant force is directly proportional to distance travel of the body. So it is an equation which you learn in the science. So equation is like that. Work done is equal to, they are saying that it is a work done by the body on the application of constant force is directly proportional to the distance traveled. So work done is equal to what? Force into distance. So let take work done is x and distance travel is y. Clear? Distance travel is y. So x is proportional to y, because they are directly saying that work done is proportional to the distance travel. And if we remove that proportional form, so here we are using any of the constant, we can write the constant is k. So k indicate what? Force. So they are asking, express this form of a equation in a two variable. So here we have a two variable, and draw the graph for the same by taking the constant force as phi unit. So k means force is given, phi unit. So what is our equation? X is equal to phi y, because k is equal to force is equal to phi unit. It is already given. Clear? And also read from the graph, work done when the distance of body is 2 unit and 0 unit. So first of all, here we can put, here first of all we are taking y is equal to 0 if distance travel is 0. So x is equal to phi in bracket 0, so answer is 0. So first coordinate is 0, 0. Then y is equal to, we can take 2 unit because they are also asking for a 2. So x is equal to phi in bracket 2, so it will be 10. So point is 10, 2, and if we are taking y is equal to 1, so 5, so 5 comma 1. Now we can also draw the graph for the same. Here x, x dashed, y dash, here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here we have an up to the 10, so we can take the scale, or you can also plot for the 10 like that, 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, up to the 10, minus 1, minus 2. So now we are plotting the graph. So first point is 0, 0, so it is here, 0, 0. Then second, it is 10, 2. So here it is 10, and here we have a, so for 2, 10. Because on a x-axis, we are taking the x is equal to, we are taking the work done, and y is equal to, we are taking distance. So first point is 0, 0, then 10, 2, 10, 2, then 5, 1, 5, 1, so it is here. So graph is in a straight line, clear, graph it is in a straight line. Clear? So it is also the linear equation, x is equal to 5y. Now we are going to our next question. Yamini and Fatima, two students of class 9 of a school, they are together contribute the 100 rupees. So we have a two girls from class 9. The name is Yamini and second it is Fatima. Both are contributing the 100 rupees towards the Prime Minister Relief Fund to help the earthquake victims. So write the linear equation which satisfied this data and also draw the graph. So we can take that like that. Let us assume the contribution of Yamini is x and the contribution of Fatima is y. Clear? Now both are gather contribute how many rupees? 100 rupees. So it is x plus y is equal to 100. Now if this y is going second side, so it become minus. Clear? It became minus. Now we are taking the different value of x or y. So first of all we can take y is equal to 0. So Fatima contribution is 0. So it means what? The contribution whole is given by Yamini only. So if we put y is equal to 0, so x is equal to 100 minus 0. So answer it is 100. Now second, if Yamini gives, Fatima gives the 10 rupees, so what is the contribution of Yamini? It is 90 rupees. Now if Yamini gives, Fatima gives the 50 rupees, so it means what? Both are give the 50 rupees. Similarly, we can also find for 70. So x is equal to 100 minus 70. So it will be 30 rupees. Clear? So contribution is given. Now we are plotting the graph. Here x, x dashed, y, y dashed. Here we can take the scale 10, 10. Clear? So we can write on x axis 1 unit is equal to 10. Similarly for on y axis once again we can take 1 unit is equal to 10 rupees. So here 0, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 10, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. We can also write here 10, 40, 50, 60, then 70, 80, 90 and 100. So now next, here we can here we haven't the need of the negative value because contribution is always in a positive integer. So next, first point is 100, 0. So it is here 100, 0 because x is 100. Then 90, 10, 90, 10. So it is here. Next 50, 50. 50, so it is here. Next 30, 70, 30, 70. So if we draw this line, so it is always a straight line, clear, it is always a straight line. So it is a graph for x plus y is equal to 100. So last question of exercise number 4.3. So in a countries like USA and Canada, temperature measure in Fahrenheit, while in India we are measuring in Celsius. So here we have a two different unit, Fahrenheit and Celsius. In Canada and USA they are measuring the temperature in Fahrenheit, while in India we are using the Celsius unit. So the linear equation that convert the Fahrenheit into the Celsius, it is given here. The equation is given, so we can also write like that: F is equal to 9/5 Celsius + 32. Now first question, draw the graph of a linear equation above using the Celsius for x-axis and Fahrenheit for a y-axis. So first of all, here we are taking the different unit. So first of all, we can take Celsius is equal to 0. So F is equal to 9/5 (0 + 32). So 9/5 × 0. So 0 + 32, answer it is 32. Then we can take Celsius is equal to 5. So 9/5 × 5. Here I am taking 5 because dropping is easy for us if you are taking 5, 10 like that unit. Otherwise what happened, the answer it is in a fraction form, so it is difficult to plot that answer on our graph paper. So that's why here we are taking 5 as our unit. So 5 cut, so 39 + 32, so it will be 41. Then we are taking 10 here, so F is equal to 9/5 × 10. So 5 × 2 = 10, so 9 × 2 = 18, so it is 50. So we can also take for a 30. So 9/5 (30 + 32). So 5, 6 = 30, 6, 9 = 54 plus 32. So 6, 86. So here now we are drawing the plot, the graph for it. So on x axis they are saying that what? Celsius. On y axis we are taking Fahrenheit. So we can also take the scale. On x axis 1 centimeter is equal to 5 Celsius. On y axis we can also take the scale. 1 unit is equal to 10 Fahrenheit. So here 5, 10, 15, 20, then 25, 30.
here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, like that.
Now, first, if we are taking Celsius is 0, then Fahrenheit is 32, so it is here. Next, if Celsius is 5, then it is 41, 5 and 41, it is here. Then 10, 50, 10 degree, then it is 50. Then 30, then 86, 30, then 86, so we are taking 70 and 80. So here it is 86. So graph, it is in a linear form. Clear, it is in a linear form. Clear, graph, it is in a its linear form. Next, now the question second, if temperature is 30 degree Celsius, then what is the temperature of Fahrenheit? We can already calculate that. If Celsius is 30, then the Fahrenheit, what is its conversion of Fahrenheit, 86 Fahrenheit? What is the temperature? It is 86 temperature. So you can directly write down answer. If the temperature, we can directly write down the answer. If temperature is 30 degree Celsius, then is equal to 86 Fahrenheit. It is the answer second. Now third, if the Fahrenheit is 95 degree, so first of all we can write down the equation, F is equal to 9 by 5 C plus 32. Now Fahrenheit is 95, it is given, so here we will put 95. Now that 32 is going second side, so it become minus. So 3, and here we have a 6. Now this term is going second side, so it will be in multiplication, and that is going on the second side, so it will be in the division. So 9, 6, clear, 9, 6, then 9, 7, sorry, 9, 7, 63, so 7, 5, it is 35, so it means what, if Fahrenheit is 95, so it is equal to the 35 degree Celsius. Now next, fourth question. If temperature is 0, so what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? If temperature is 0 degree Celsius, so here first of all we are writing the equation. If temperature is 0 degree Celsius, so 9 by 5 into 0, so it is 0. So it equal to how many Fahrenheit? 32 Fahrenheit. Second question, and if the temperature is 0 Fahrenheit, once again, if temperature is 0 Fahrenheit, now it is equal to, that 32 is going second side, so it is minus 32. Now convert, so minus 32 into 5 divide with 9, so 32 5 is a 5, 3 is 15 plus 60, 160, so answer is minus 160 upon 9, so it will be in the point form, 9 ones are 9, so 16 minus 9 7 0, now 9 7s are 63, so once again 7, so it will be approximately minus 70.777. next, last, is a temperature which is numerically the same in the both Fahrenheit and Celsius, so it means what, last question, fifth, once again we can write the equation, 9 by 5 C plus 32. Now they are asking what, which numerically value represent the Fahrenheit and Celsius both are equal, and if it is yes, then find its value. So it means what? F is equal to C. Now replace F with C. So that is going second side, so it become minus. Now phi is our LCM, so phi C minus 9C upon phi is equal to 32. So it is minus 4C, and that phi is going second side, so it is in multiplication. So C is equal to that minus 4 is going second side. So 4, so here we have a 2, so here we have 16, once again 2, so here we have a 8. So 8 5 is a 40. So it means what? If we are taking minus 40 degree Celsius, so at that time both unit will be remain same, Fahrenheit and Celsius. Last exercise of our chapter, it is exercise number 4.4. So it is actually based on equation of the lines parallel to x and y axis. So let's start our question number 1. So give the geometric representation of y is equal to 3 in a 1 variable and a 2 variable. So if you want to draw the geometric representation with a 1 variable, so we can draw the one single line only. Here we have a then 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, minus 1, minus 2. So here they are saying that what? Y is equal to 3. So it is here, y is equal to 3. Next, in a 2 variable. So if you want to draw in a 2 variable, so it is like that. Here y, y dash 0, x, x dash, then 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. So here y is equal to 3. So it is here y is equal to 3. So we can draw the line like that. So it means what? If y is equal to 3, so it is parallel with x axis, and sometimes they are also giving x is equal to 3, so it is line like that. So it is parallel with y axis. Clear? So it means what? If we are asking in a 1 variable, so you can draw the only one number line, and if it is asking in a 2 variable, so we can draw the x as well as y axis both. So it means what? Here we have a number of point, these and these. So it means what? 1, 3, then 2, 3, 3, 3, then 4, 3. So y value will be fixed. Clear? Y value will be fixed, 4, 3. Here 0, 3, then minus 1, 3, like that. Clear? So it means what? The y will be remain same, but the value of x will be change. Now the last question of that exercise, question 2. It is the same as our question number 1. So equation is given, 2x plus 9 is equal to 0. So that is going second side, so it is minus 9. So x is equal to minus 9/2. So answer it is 4.5, because half of 9 it is 4.5. Now in a 1 variable, so we can draw the number line, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. Now x is equal to minus 4.5, so it is between 4 and 5, so x is equal to minus 4.5. Now in a 2 variable, so in a 2 variable, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, x, x dash, y, y dash, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5.
Now x is equal to minus 4.5, so it is here. So we can draw the one line like that. So it is x is equal to minus 4.5. So what is its coordinate? Minus 4.5 comma 0, minus 4.5 comma plus 1, minus 4.5 comma plus 2, minus 4.5 comma minus 1, like that. So it means what? The value of x coordinate will be remain fixed, but the coordinate of y will be different. So it means what? If x is equal to minus 4.5, so it is parallel with y axis. X coordinate is given, then it is parallel to the y axis. And if the y is equal to 3 is given, so it means what? It is parallel with the x axis. So that is our last concept, equation of the lines which is parallel to x and y axis. So now our chapter number 4 will be over.